Hello, and welcome to this presentation on the U4301B PCIe and NVMe Protocol Analyzer. My name is Don Scheneker. I am the product manager for the PCIe and NVMe protocols. Here we have before us the U4301B Protocol Analyzer as a module plugged into our AXE frame, and I'm looking at some packets here. We're connected up to a link where we're testing an NVMe device using the exerciser, also from Keysight Technologies. In doing the testing, I'll demonstrate how we connect it up and how you can do all the basic operations. Now I'd like to demonstrate a little bit of the connection setup and operation. First off, the cables that connect to the module, we need to connect those to our interposer. The interposer that is for slot attachment. So I take the cables and attach that to my interposer that snap right in on the front there. And then I can move this up and put it on my backplane for capturing and exercising data. And plug that in there. On top of my interposer here, I will plug in my device under test. In this case, it's an NVMe disk drive. So I'm going to plug that in on top. And then to communicate that to that and do the testing, I'm going to use the Keysight Technologies U4305A PCIe exerciser. And I plug that in on the other slot here to communicate to that. Now I just connect power and a USB connection, and I'm ready to begin testing. Now that we have our device set up and connected, I want to demonstrate how to actually start capturing data. First step is, I can see on the LEDs across the front that it is not seeing any traffic upstream or downstream, but it's also looking for a buy one link. So my first configuration is I go to the setup area here. In that setup area, I tell it that the link width is by 4, because that is the link width of my SSD that I'm testing here. So now I see that it has changed to there's no activity upstream or downstream on the by 4 link. To train the link, I bring up my exerciser interface real quick, and I say start training and turn on the power to my device under test, and I can see that 4 upstream, 4 downstream, the blue indicates that it's at Gen 3 operation. Now I can go back to my exerciser, start a capture by pressing on the run button, and it will starts processing data. After it captures data, it stops automatically, and now I can click on show. And in show, it starts showing me the traffic that was occurring on this link. I can see skip ordered sets, end data streams, flow control updates, some of the basic traffic is occurring. Now that we're capturing data, I want to demonstrate a few of the analysis tools that you have available. In the top area here, we're seeing packet by packet what was captured across the link. The tabs across the bottom demonstrate different aspects of the information. So for example, if I select up here the update flow control, I can at the bottom select the tab details, and it has a complete breakdown of that packet. And as I select packets, the details at the bottom show me exactly what information is there. There's a header view where I can look at just the headers. If there's data, I'll be able to look at the payload. For lanes, I can look at each individual lane and see what byte occurred on which lane. There are additional tabs in here that show me traffic overview that include a compute button. That compute is a process through of everything that's in the buffer. And here we can see that there were, 5,000 packets in the buffer, a couple of CRC errors in this capture in here. And as I look at that data, if I want to see that over time, there's a button over here to enable the chart that gives me a linear view of everything that occurred in my buffer here. And I can see when each of those transactions happened. So I can see when the errors occurred. And I double click on that, and it will take me to that area of the buffer. I can scroll around and find that. I can also select directly on the number, and it takes me to that individual packet, but I can see where those occurred in the capture buffer. Also, when I hover over any packet, it highlights for me what the error condition is. In this case, a bad 16-bit CRC was in that packet as it went across the link. If I go to LTSSM overview, again there's a compute button. I press compute. It stayed steady in L0 for the entire packet trace. There's a transaction decode that gets into detail. Again, there's a compute button, a performance overview that I can process through and statistically see what is occurring across the link and what kind of activity there is. There's no real activity in here, so it did not demonstrate that. All these compute buttons, if I want those to be automatically computed for me, at the top area there's a compute all on run. If I select that, whenever I run a capture, it will automatically process the data immediately upon finishing the capture and present the information that is captured across the link. So in this capture, it actually had some packets in there that gave me some utilization of 0.03 gigabits per second, but I can see that there was activity there. If I wanted to plot additional information, this legend over here allows me to select additional bus statistics that I want to plot on that link. So if I want link utilization, I select that and it adds that to my graph automatically. So I can see exactly what's happening there. Easy tools to select what I want to view. Now that we've seen some of the tools that you can use to analyze the data in the buffer, we need to take advantage of tools to control what goes into the buffer. If we go back up to my setup, one of the areas of my connection setup is the lane width and how my operation is, but the second is my capture setup of how big a buffer do I want to operate with. I have a very small buffer right now. I can easily increase that in size to some other value of what I want to capture. There's also a tab here for tuning. Because we're connecting into the middle of a Gen 3 link, we have to adjust some of the signal levels to make sure we get a reliable data capture. Default tuning usually works, but if customized tuning is required, it's all automatic from within this menu. Another area is my trigger and filtering menu. First off, triggering, if I want to trigger on a packet, it's a simple drag and drop interface. In my selection window, I can select different packet types. I can go to packets, Gen 3 packets, go to a memory read, and trigger on a memory read just by a simple drag and drop. If I want to get into details of that memory read, I double click on that, and it lets me do a bit level trigger to define what I am looking for in my capture buffer. So with that, I can do a quick capture, and now I am going to trigger on some data. Start my capture. It's waiting for an event to happen. If I start some traffic in the background, let me just start the traffic here. Now I move that back out of the way, and it triggered, and right there where it's, well, let me jump back to my trigger point, and there's the memory reads. That easy to trigger and capture on something. But I'm getting a lot of other things into my buffer. I want to filter. So I go back to that trigger and capture filter menu, and there's a global filter right here. So I can filter out everything that I don't want capture. So like those end data streams, if I do not want those, I can simply select those and not capture them. If I don't want skip ordered sets, select that, and those will be filtered out. Now I click OK. When I do a new capture, that is my new operations of what's being captured in my buffer. I am generating lots of traffic here, and just so you know what the red packets are, they're unsupported requests. I have data flowing across this link of several different memory reads, but the types of packets I'm generating are the unsupported requests are coming back with errors for me. But I can easily see those. It's showing me unsupported request. My transaction decode will highlights the information. It even shows me things such as, if I go down here, I'm seeing some red transactions, and it's telling me that it's missing the completion. These happen to occur because it's the very end of the buffer. We didn't capture the completion for these two, but my transaction decode is doing lots of different analysis to show me what's in this capture buffer. Easy triggering, easy control. Now, if you want to do more advanced types of operation, that trigger menu even has an advanced trigger option. So rather than a simple trigger, which was the drag and drop interface, I can click on advanced trigger, and an advanced trigger lets me do a sequence of events. And I have one defined here that is looking for a memory read, starts a timer, and then looks for the completion packet to be returned from the other side. If it does not see that within 2 microseconds, that's my trigger condition. Otherwise, look for the next event. So I select advanced trigger using this routine. Okay, now I start the run and it will start capturing data and looking for that condition. And what we're seeing in here is if I go back from my trigger point, you will see that there's no completions to those memory reads, and the last completion was clear back over 2 microseconds before that last memory read. So there was a long pause in my traffic in here. Here's that completion, it's unsupported, but then I had lots of memory reads and no completions. So simple triggering to find events, very complex events. Very powerful tool that can allow you to control your capture buffer. As you can see, the U4301B PCIe protocol analyzer has a lot of different very powerful tools to enable you to do the testing and validation of your designs that you need to access the data in a quick and easy fashion. These tools are designed with you in mind to access into the detail of PCIe operation, whether it be performance or error conditions or finding the difficult to capture situations. I thank you for spending some time with me to look at this analyzer, and I wish you well in the future.